मैं पीयूष वेद प्रकाश गोयल ईश्वर की शपथ लेता हूं कि जो विषय संघ के मंत्री के रूप में मेरे विचार के लिए लाया जाएगा अथवा मुझे ज्ञात होगा उसे किसी व्यक्ति या व्यक्तियों को तब के सिवाय।
The oath-taking ceremony of Modi 3.0 underway. The pecking order very clear. Prime Minister Modi was the first to go, followed by Rajnath Singh, and then Amit Shah, followed by Nitin Gadkari, and then Shivraj Singh Chauhan, who got a loud cheer as he got up to be sworn in by the President of India. Let me go across to our guests who continue to be with us as we continue to see, one BJP MP after another being sworn in as a cabinet minister. So we'll just stay with the visuals that are coming to us from Rashtrapati Bhavan and speak to our guests. Madhavan Narayan continues to be with us, Nilanjan Mukhopadhyay with us as well, and Ruhi Tiwari, senior journalist, with us as well. Ruhi, what we are seeing on our screens, to a certain degree, is about continuity as well. Yes, you have a new face. In fact, you have two new faces that we saw being sworn in before we slipped into a quick break. Manohar Lal Khattar and Shivraj Singh Chauhan. Ex-chief ministers, ex-BJP chief ministers who've done extremely well, now coming to the centre. And they're coming to the government. They're not going to the party. So a degree of continuity there as well, as we see Dharmendra Pradhan walk up.
Right. No, so of course there is continuity because a lot of ministers in the previous government, look, if you look at the first term of the Modi government, right, their bench strength looked very weak because obviously they were struggling, they were grappling to find people. I think they recovered ground and they sort of matched bench strength in their second term. They had, various kinds of ministers. They brought in outside people to take, domain experts to take over various ministries. Mm-hmm. So I think that degree of continuity would continue from the second term because there are people now who've settled into ministries, who've settled into governance, into administration. And yes, the BJP government would benefit from some seasoned politicians, some seasoned administrators like Shivraj Singh Chauhan. Manohar Lal Khattar wasn't the best chief minister for BJP as far as Haryana was concerned or any state was concerned, but certainly with Shivraj Singh Chauhan, it's an experienced hand. The BJP would need people like these, so it's going to be a mix. It's certainly a mix of the older faces as well as some new faces. Also, allies would be a big thing as we've been discussing in this particular government. They would have to, and they are giving adequate representation to their allies. Faces like Chirag Paswan, for instance, would be seen. So. One interesting point that was made earlier by Mr. Mukhopadhyay was, why is Anurag Thakur missing? Because he's really not run foul of this government at all. It's not as if he's done anything for this government to be unhappy with him. So it's an interest that he would be made party president, a young face. I'm just not sure whether Mr. Thakur at this point has the political maturity that would be needed to handle BJP at this point, particularly because now allies are becoming important. You've not done exceptionally well. You've not done as well in these elections as you had thought you would. You have very important state elections coming up over the next few years. So I'm not sure whether he has the political maturity or the ability to steer the party through a time like this. But it was an interesting theory. I forgot to mention it then, but it was an interesting theory that he made.
There are lots of interesting theories, including some conspiracy theories about sabotage as far as the BJP's performance in Rajasthan, in Uttar Pradesh is concerned as well. We'll leave that to another time. There is now a semi-official press note that is giving us more details to the ceremony, that is oath-taking ceremony that is currently underway. We are being told that 72 ministers are being sworn in today. Of course, they are led by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. So the new team will include 30 cabinet ministers, 5 ministers of state with independent charge, with one of them we know, Praful Patel has already said thanks but no thanks, and you'll have 36 ministers of state. So 30 cabinet ministers are being sworn in along with the Prime Minister today, in all 72 ministers being sworn in. They come from all across India. They represent the 24 states and regions within all states. The leadership will cut across social groups. This becomes important because caste played a very important role in these elections. The press note says that 27 OBCs, 10 scheduled caste, 5 scheduled tribe, and 5 minorities, including a record 18 senior ministers, will be heading ministries. 11 NDA ally ministers are being sworn in as well. The number we had put was 12. Turns out it is 11 NDA allies who are being sworn in as well. You'll have at least 43 ministers. These are interesting numbers that are coming in. You'll have at least 43 ministers who will be serving a third term in parliament. 39 having been ministers in the government of India before. So which means there is a big emphasis on continuity. Continuity is important because, you know, when you're dealing with complex ministries, say like the Ministry of HRD, say like the Ministry of Defence, or say like the Ministry of Finance, you take time to settle down. Once you've settled down, that's where your experience comes in. That's when your experience counts. To that end, we have a certain degree of continuity in this government as well.